Hello everyone, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday, episode number 3. Today we're gonna take a look into how to build a desktop. So I'm not gonna show you how to physically build them. This presentation is more focused on how do you select components and build the actual desktop. So let's get into it. So let's look into CPU. So all you have to understand in CPU is what is your budget. Know your budget and you can select your CPU quite easily. Second most important part is what you're gonna use that CPU for. As in gaming, you only need a 6 to 8 core maximum. Professional work where you are doing video rendering, CAD modeling, you need as high as you can get. And if you are doing home theater, buy AMD APU, which gives you the best onboard graphics, and you will be happy with that. So know your use case and know your budget. That way you can choose your CPU. And if you need a way to compare those CPU, use cpuboss.com. That's a very good site. So now let's move on to the motherboard. Now in motherboard, it's everything connects to it. So all you have to understand is every CPU comes with a chipset. Basically a chipset that it will support. You can't just mismatch these things. So if you selected a CPU, please check what chipset it has, and listed as supported chipset. X99, there are many numbers, X87, 77. So please look into the chipset, which is supported for your CPU. After you have selected the chipset, I would advise don't go for gimmicky motherboards that have way too many features, as in overclocking, dual BIOS, and all those things. Generally, those things crash way more often than normal server grade motherboard or even a normal run of the mill motherboard. And the one very easy way to determine how long your motherboard is gonna last is look at the warranty length. Generally, they will come from minimum of 2 years to you can easily go upwards of 5 years. Server motherboards can generally give you 5 years. So please pay attention. And please look into the manual of a motherboard. You can generally get a digital copy of that also. What is the QVL? Basically, qualified vendor list that is there. That will tell you which RAM is supported and tested with your motherboard. So, and in nowadays, when we have this small port on your motherboard where you can directly connect NVMe SSD, sometimes qualified vendor list also include which sort of SSDs has been tested with it. Generally, it's a good idea to follow that qualified vendor list. So these things you have to keep in mind. Now we have selected CPU. Now we have a motherboard. Let's look into the RAM. Now in RAM, simplest thing you have to understand is more is better. However, one thing I have to stress is point of diminishing return. So what does that mean? Basically, think of it this way. Let's say all you are doing is light media browsing and watching movies. Buying more than 8 GB, you have just wasted your money. You could have spent that money to buy a bigger hard drive where you can have stored more content. So there is a point of diminishing return. Heck, let's say all you do is gaming, more than 16 GB RAM is quite pointless for you. And let's say you do light video editing and all that, 32 GB is your point. Now, if you do 4K, 10-bit and virtual machine systems and all that, yes, at that point, go higher than that. But generally, you can easily reach your point of diminishing return. So generally, it's a good idea to be below it. Then you have to understand, RAMs are rated on two factors. One is their capacity, gigabyte, and second is megahertz. Now, do not waste your money on high megahertz RAM, simply because unless you are doing virtual machine, they will not give you any tangible, perceivable benefits. That is that. And some RAM supports ECC, which is error correcting code. It is generally a good idea if you are doing CAD modeling or long rendering where your CPU is going to be on for 10-12 hours, is generally a good idea to invest in that. But do check every three things supports it: RAM, your motherboard, your CPU. Only then you can use ECC. And you might find that gaming RAMs have a much lower warranty compared to normal RAM. So use RAM warranty guide as your scale of quality and performance. If they are giving you, same company sometimes give you 5-year warranty on normal RAM and only 3-year warranty on gaming RAM, just understand this. It's better to have a RAM that lasts longer than a RAM that, it's a fancy heat sink. So please spend your money wisely. Now you can buy this or this, no denying that, just spend your money wisely. Now then we come to storage. Now, this is the latest kid in the block, NVMe SSD. This run through PCI Express, basically the same slot you plug your graphics card in. This has the same connector wiring and all that done for it. Now, it is very fast. This sucker can go up to 1.5 gigabytes write and almost 3 gigabytes of read. However, you're not gonna feel it. So let's say you had a normal hard drive, you went from hard drive to SSD, you're gonna notice a day and night difference. However, if you go from this to this, SSD to NVMe, you're not gonna notice that difference. So please do have your expectation very thoroughly adjusted. You're not gonna notice a, you know, day and night difference. You, of course, your system will be faster, your games will load a bit faster. But point is, right now, very few applications can actually use the performance this provides. So if you can choose between these two, go with this. It is a bit better. However, if this is costing you more, go with this. You will not regret it. And hard drive, generally, they are the cheap and best. And they, the easiest way to find is it really cheap and best is divide the cost with the terabyte capacity. That way, you will get what's known as GB per dollar or per rupees. And based on that, you can actually calculate compared to what you need. Generally, 2 terabyte right now as we speak is the best price to capacity that you can get. So multiple 2 terabytes would be cheaper than 1 3 terabyte or 1 4 terabyte hard drive. So price per gigabyte is more important. Now let's look into the visual heart of the computer, the GPU. Now, this is very important for you. Please pay attention that all graphics cards come in cycles. Each cycle lasts 3-year time period. So if you buy a graphics card at the beginning of a cycle, your graphics card gonna be up to date in terms of its architecture for 3 years. Like for instance, when I bought my graphics card, I was this close to buying 900 series graphics card. However, I already knew 10 series graphics were coming out, so I waited and I bought that as soon as they came out. Now, let's say for in this year, in 2018, you bought 10 series graphics card. Here's the deal. Before this year is out, 11 series graphics card will enter. So please check the graphics card cycle. They only do 3 years, and AMD and Nvidia both are synced. So they both release graphics card at the same time. So please be mindful of that. Otherwise, you will probably regret it. Specifically with the rise of Bitcoin mining and all those things, the graphics card price are too high. So imagine you bought something thinking that's gonna be latest and next month it's gonna be released, you know, the architecture will be outdated. So, and please check your monitor refresh rate before you buy a very powerful graphics card. Like most people have graphics card that can support, you know, a very high refresh rate that can render games at very high rate, but their monitor can only support 60 hertz. So please check whether you have a gaming monitor or not. If you don't buy very high-end graphics card. Now, this is one crucial part. VRAM, the 8GB, 6GB or 12GB rating, it cannot be added to. You cannot put 2 graphics and add them, because let's say you are running a game, the texture information would be stored in both of them. That's why you will not get double the RAM capacity. It cannot be like, okay, half of the texture goes into one graphics card, half of the texture goes into another graphics card. It cannot be done that way. So if your VRAM is, let's say, 4GB, you cannot have 2 graphics card and be like 8GB. No, you will still have 4GB. So please be mindful of that. So generally try to buy as high of a VRAM as you can. Now we come to power supply unit. I cannot stress this enough. Do not cheap out on your power supply. I have seen places that cheap out on a power supply and suffered horrible consequences because of that, and some places that made it work. Generally, the places that made it work is might be your office or things like that, because they have already spent a lot of money into online UPS. Basically, they are taking care of the power before it goes to power supply unit. That's why they can afford cheap power supplies. However, please do not cheap out, even if you have an online UPS. And pay attention to the warranty. Like this is very easy place to figure out. This component has the second longest life in your PC. You can build like 2-3 computers in it with one power supply. So please pay attention to the warranty. Some come as a long warranty as 5 years, 8 year warranty is also available in this version. And this scale, 80 plus, is a very good scale to figure out how the quality of your power supply. And you, there is simple, the higher the better. you have 80 plus, which simply means it has more than 80% efficiency. Then you have 80 plus gold, 80 plus platinum, 80 plus titanium. 80 plus titanium goes upwards of 90% efficiency. So that's how you're gonna check whether how efficient your system is. And please don't buy overpowered, like, you know, let's say you calculated you need 600 watt, you're gonna buy 1200 watt, don't do that. Because that will reduce the efficiency. Generally, all power supply are very efficient at 80% of their capacity, not 10% or 20% of their capacity. So you're gonna be wasting money if you buy a very overpowered power supply unit. And you could have spent that money more wisely on hard drive or RAM. So let's look into the where you're gonna put all this. So PC case is the longest living thing in your computer. I have a case that I have already built two computers in. So investing in a good case is a good investment. However, you have to understand few things. PC case affects few things of your computer. First, how quiet or loud it is. If you have a very big case which requires multiple fans, like 8 or 9 fans, is gonna be loud. If you have a small case which is well designed, which only needs 4 fans, and you'll be like very quiet PC. Some PC cases are specifically engineered and designed with sound suppression in mind. They have sound absorption phone, and they do a lot of engineering to make sure it's quiet. So your sound is directly controlled by your cabinet basically. And this is if the cabinet is well built and well spec'd out. Like, let's say you put the right size of cabinet in your computer. Like, let's say you have only one graphics card and you bought a full size, full tower basically. And basically there would be a lot of turbulence in air, because air does not have, like, you know, coming in, going out. That will cause a lot of turbulence and it will increase the temperature. You have to put more fan, then you will end up with a more noisy environment. So just because, like, you can buy a big case, make sure you can actually use it. If you have liquid cooling, of course, go with as big as you can do it. So these things affect your how long your component is going to live due to thermal management and how noisy it's going to be. And the, investing in these are actually a good idea, because they actually can live for 10-20 years. Now we come to monitor, the thing that is the output of a computer. So there are three main categories. One is your normal entertainment category, normal, basic, everyday that you see, super cheap. However, you can buy certain unique monitors where you can get a 21:9 ultra wide monitor. Basically, if you do a lot of movie watching, this monitor will satisfy you, because you can watch movies in this with no black bars. There won't be a black bar on top or bottom. So then we come to professional monitor. Now, professional monitor are the most expensive. And professional monitor generally boasts a very good color reproduction, color accuracy, and they generally come with VESA mount on their back, so you can adjust the height or put it on your own stand, because a professional is going to be staring into monitor much longer than anyone else would, like 10-12 hours is common. So you want to make sure you don't stress out. So they generally come with very good mounting units. And then we come to gaming. Now, gaming, all that simply means, generally means, is very high refresh rate, and it has to be above 60. Generally, above 60, you only go to 120. There is nothing in between. Some monitors do come with 90 hertz, but it's generally wise to buy 120 hertz. And there is 144 hertz, which is not that common nowadays, because the cost goes way too high. So you these are the monitor. So can one monitor do all these things? Yes, but like they are generally, if you want the most fast experience in your Counter-Strike, you're gonna buy a gaming monitor. You want to do a lot of video coloring work, you wanna buy a professional monitor. And you just want to, like, you know, have a normal computing experience, you're gonna go with ultra wide or a normal monitor. So right tool for the right job. So thank you for watching. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, please like. If you disliked it, please dislike. Leave a comment, subscribe, and if you're free, press the bell icon. Thank you for watching.